So hello friends, once again welcome to you all here. And from today I'm going to begin with the video series on the syllabus of English Literature UGC NET, unit number 1, drama. And in drama writings we are going to learn about different drama writings of different ages of English literature. So basically British literature will be on focus, and non-British literature afterwards also. So in today's video I'm going to begin with the drama writings in the age of revival. In the age of revival, the beginning of drama will be discussed here, and the some of the important plays, miracle plays, mystery plays and morality plays and major dramas of the age will be discussed in this video. So friends, let's begin today's video with the presentation of the important facts of drama in the age of revival. So friends, here we can see the age of revival and history of English literature, unit number 1, drama. And it is as per the new syllabus of English literature, NTA NET 2019 onwards, it was implemented, friends. And in this particular video, we are going to discuss about the mystery plays, miracle plays, morality and major dramas of the age. And let me tell you that age of revival was, the timeline of this age was 1400 to 1550. So 150 years of this age was there. And first of all, let's discuss about mystery plays, which can be defined as the mystery play. So friends, it was popular in the 15th century, and the stories of the Bible were dramatized there. Yes, so in the 15th century this kind of plays were very very popular and famous, because the stories of the Bible, the biblical themes are used to dramatize the story for the drama, and people were liking this too much because it was based on Bible, that's why. Then it was religious in theme. The stories of the fall of Lucifer, Cain and Abel and Noah and the flood, the nativity and the passion of Christ's life was a common theme. So these are the different themes, the topics on which the mystery plays were written and performed. Yes, and these plays were performed between May and June months. Between May and June months, these plays were performed by the actors. And during a festival named as Corpus Christi. Corpus Christi is a festival, and during this festival, these mystery plays were performed by the actors. And by this festival also, it is also named as, or we can say it is known as the Corpus Christi plays in the history. Yes. So another name for mystery play is Corpus Christi plays. Yes. So remember this one. Then often set on fairs and celebrations. So fairs and celebrations are very much important, friends, here, on which these plays were performed or set. Okay, so basically outside the city it was performed, where the fair is there and celebration, any kind of celebration is there. And most of the fairs and celebrations were based on religions and religious themes. So on such set, these plays were performed by the actors. Then written in cycles on a specific biblical event. So if there is any specific biblical event, these plays were written, and these were written in cycles. So one play follows another play, and then the another play is followed by the another play. So a cycle is there in the mystery play. Then four manuscripts of these cycles which survived belong to York, Chester, Wakefield and other unknown place. So friends, there are four different manuscripts. Four cycles are famous of these mystery plays, and which are survived, and these are belonging to York, Chester, Wakefield and other unknown place. So we have to remember this one. It can be asked. Then example of mystery play is Second Shepherd's Play. One very famous example which is survived and it is named as Second Shepherd's Play. And it is a story of three shepherds called Gib and Dow. So three shepherds are there named as called Gib and Dow. And their story is narrated in this mystery play named as Second Shepherd's Play. So friends, that's all for mystery play. Let's revise some of the important things. Mystery play was written in 15th century and it was based on biblical events and themes. And particularly the life of Christ is a common theme here. Most of the plays were written on the life of Christ. And it was performed between May and June months and during the festival named as Corpus Christi. And by because of that, it is also named as Corpus Christi plays in the history. And always written in the cycles. So these are important things from mystery plays. Then friends, miracle plays. Miracle plays are very important in terms of representing the lives of saints. Yes, friends, the saints were there in the history and their lives are here narrated in miracle plays, the miracles done by them. It was based on those miracles. And it is revolving around the real or fictitious account of the lives, miracles and martyrdom of saints. So that is very important. Most of the plays or the miracle plays were based on the lives and miracles done by the saints, their martyrdom, their their goodness, their kindness, their lives. So many events were incorporated there to narrate such plays. So it basically it was revolving around those events. And the conversion of Saint Paul and the play of the sacrament are two examples of miracle plays here, friends. Two major examples of miracle plays are the conversion of Saint Paul and the play of sacrament. These are two important examples. So let's revise once again. Miracle plays are based on the miracles done by the saints and their lives and their martyrdom. And two important examples are there. Conversion of Saint Paul and the play of the sacrament. These are two examples of miracle plays, friends. Now, morality plays. Morality plays are basically based on the allegorical characters and the lessons. As the title says that morality. So morals are there. It has allegorical characters and taught lessons in it. And these dramas are based on allegories of the life of man, his temptation and sinning, quest for salvation. These are the major themes of this type of plays. So basically moral is important here. Lessons are important here. And it is based on preaching to the humanity, preaching or showing the way, showing the direction to the humanity by moral stories, and cultivation of character is important here. So let's revise. Allegorical characters are there, teaching the lessons, and the allegories are based on the life of man, his temptation, his quest for salvation, and important things are preaching the humanity and cultivation of character. These are important in the stories of morality plays. Now friends, the examples are here. Three important examples are there. Castle of Perseverance, written around 1425, a story of man opening with his birth and his death. That is the story. And then Every Man, very popular one. It is a morality play written around 1500, and its another title is The Summoning of Every Man. Is its full title. Summoning of Every Man, that is its full title. And it has 900 lines, and it is a short play of only 900 lines, friends. Then Skelton's Magnificence, written by John Skelton. It is a political morality play. That is a different one, but it is a morality play, but political morality play written by John Skelton, named as Skelton's Magnificence. So these are the examples of morality play, friends. You can note these examples in your notebook. Then friends, major dramas in the age of revival. I have tried to outline some of the important dramas here in this video. First one is Fulgens and Lucrece. Fulgens and Lucrece, it was written around 1497 and it is the first play in vernacular language and the first secular play survived in English. So two many very important characteristic of this play is first play in vernacular language and secular play. First secular play survived in English. And it is also the first play giving importance to woman character, because there is one woman character in this play, a very important one character. We can say the protagonist of the play. And it is also in debate form. The whole play is in debate form, having a subplot also for the first time introduced in writing drama. So this particular play in the age of revival is very important in the matter of first vernacular play, then first secular play, and first play to give importance to woman character, and it is written in debate form. There is a kind of discussion there, and it has also a subplot. For the first time, a subplot was introduced in writing drama in this particular play. Then friends, Nature is another play, and it is a morality play by Medwell. The first play was also by Medwell, and the second play, Nature, a morality play by Medwell, story of conflict between virtues and vices. That is important, friends. A story of conflict is there between virtues and vices, so good and evil things. The discussion is there, the conflict is there, is narrated by Medwell, the writer of this play. Then friends, of the finding of truth, of the finding of truth, that is also an important play, and it is written by Henry Medwell once again, and it is an interlude, a play within a play, we can say. So first play to introduce full person here. And the next play is Four Elements, written around 1520. It is also an interlude, but written by John Russell. John Russell wrote this work, and it is also known as the morality play. So it is an interlude also, and a morality play also, Four Elements. And which are the four elements we will see here? There is a conflict between good and evil once again. And four elements are nature, studies, and desire and experience. So four different elements are used here: nature, studies, desire, and experience. It may be asked in the exam which four elements are incorporated in the play, Four Elements, the morality play. So you can note it down. Then friends, King Johan, written in 1538. It is written by John Bell, and it is the first historical verse play and a morality play. So it is a morality play, but also known as the first historical verse play in the history. So King Johan is written by John Bell, is a historical verse play. Then friends, the four PPS or PP, written in 1544. So the four PS or four PP are Palmer, Pardoner, Pedler, and Apothecary. So these are four P's we can see here. Okay, on which this play is written. The debate is there. The story is based on the debate, the discussion among these four characters: Palmer, Pardoner, Pedler, and Apothecary. Then friends, other plays, important plays in the age of revival include Johan the Husband in 1533, then the play of Wither 1533, a play of Love 1534, the Pastime of People 1529, and Gentleness and Nobility, written in between 1525 to 27. So these are important one also. But those which were very important, I explained those place here with some important facts. And friends, these facts will be very much important for you in the exam. So that's all for today. In the next video, I will discuss about the topic of drama in the Elizabethan age. Very important age, friends, and the development of drama writing, comedy and tragedy writing, the beginning of comedy and tragedy, and the pre-Shakespearean drama, university wits will be there, and Shakespearean dramas and all the major facts for UGC NET exam of this particular age and the drama writing in this age will be discussed in the next video. So for that you have to subscribe to my channel for such videos, and let me tell once again that I will incorporate all the topics of drama of all the units of English literature syllabus in my videos one by one gradually. Okay, and after these videos I will create the videos on MCQs for the English literature exams. Okay, so keep watching these videos, and thank you for being with me in this video, and thank you once again.